我觉着Richmond 就是自然环境啊非常好，气候啊，还有人文环境也好，就是人们都非常友善，街道上也不像北京那边特别人多，特别嘈杂。说实话，我觉得上课的时间呢，不是太长时间，因为我还有我来这以后1年以后就有个第二个孩子嘛，我真是没有时间学。但是我现在学习呢，主要是读读小说啊，读读看看那个简单的报纸。但是确实也不容易，我觉得好像是对我学习英文。我觉得在这里，其实生活起来，对于我成年来说，生活起来，像我英文不好的，挺方便，也挺方便的。假如你像我去医院，我原来去医院的时候，刚来的时候，去检查嘛，我都不知道，医院就给我提供一个免费的汉语，就是翻译，给我们提供嘛。你去到哪儿都有。就是有中文帮助，我觉得这生活起来非常方便。
When we were living in Dunbar, and we were quite involved with that neighborhood, and it was filled with Italian and Greeks, and some of them first situation immigrants. And I was told numerous times by their children and the adults that we were brought up to make sure that we did not talk Italian or Greek between ourselves in the presence of people that don't understand that language. We don't get that here, particularly from the Chinese community, I'm sorry to say. Where some of the clashes occur, that some people have problems getting by, are the common everyday courtesies and civilities that don't perhaps exist or are not common in other cultures, having to be having to interact or be affected by those when you're used to norms that come out of your own culture.
I don't think this is very true, because I met a lot of people that all new residents here. They are really trying very hard to integrate with this community. Everyone, I guess everyone, if they want love this place, I think they love this place, so they came here. Yeah, that's the first. So everyone come here, they want to integrate. Yeah, become a part of Canada. Yeah, I see. Yeah, that's what I do. I think the government should do a little more propaganda about how to the new immigrants how to settle down here. Yeah, people just don't know. They just don't know how to get the information.
I think everyone is very welcome here, and you should involve to get everyone together to improve or help the country. And do your contribution, not just be selfish or just kind of tiny your own group. I don't think that's the right idea.
You don't learn really what people's experiences are from the media. So in other words, when I'm in the playground and say there's another mom or dad there, and my son is playing with them, and let's say they're from Beijing or wherever, and hear, oh, what is your husband doing over there? And well, he's doing that, and you hear about why they're here, why they love Canada, and that. You really get to understand, the people are just people, right? And I think that's the way we connect is person to person in that way. I don't think it's necessarily government's role to force communities together, force integration. That's never going to connect people together. And I understand it's hard if you don't speak a language to connect with someone else who doesn't. That's a huge barrier. I understand that. That's not something that you force change upon. Change is something that comes within the individual.
其实每个人就是大多数人都认为哈，就融入这社会非常重要。但是我觉得对于我来说，融入这社会，真正想完全的融入这社会确实挺难的。一个是语言的问题，还有一个是文化的差异，文化不同就是你产生的思维方式也不同。我觉得是不是一件容易的事儿，真正想融入，我觉得可能大多数人是想融入。